What do faith families do? We talk a lot about biblical community. It's biblical. You see this in Acts.
Yeah.
And that makes perfect sense. On a practical level, it's like, okay, I'm in a faith family. What do we do? What would they look like?
Sure. Okay, there's really five core elements that you would see in a faith family. First of all, you'd have a scripture base. And so what does that look like? Well, it doesn't mean that someone's going to be there preaching for 45 minutes at a right. small group. But what you will see is you'll see the community looking at Scripture, trying to put it into practice. And so in many ways, it's much more of a practical application. It's not just saying, what does the Scripture say? Yes, we'll do that. But it's more, how do we put that into practice? Second thing that you'd see is an element of prayer. And so both you'll be praying for each other, and you know it's not feasible here to pray for everyone in this room on a specific individual basis. And so in small groups, you have that opportunity then to put out a prayer request and have a group of people pray for you, and then also pray for the community at large. Third thing is there's going to be an element of breaking of bread and confession, Christ-centered mm-hmm. community. And so what that means is that not only are you reading the Scripture, but you're measuring yourself by the Scripture, and you can say, wow, I'm not measuring up. I'm not hitting where I need to be. And so what do you do with that? Well, you start by going back to the cross. You go and you confess, and you remember what Jesus did on the cross. And so we're going to have a lot of breaking of bread. Fourth thing that we're going to have is we're going to practice hospitality together. So there's really an element throughout this community that I think we need, even in our church here, that you need to connect with people. And so you need to have the opportunity to have people get to know you better. You can have a meal together. You can invite your neighbors and your friends in. Backyard Bible clubs is an example of ways to practice hospitality. Have people come in and do things. And then lastly is the last thing is just to have a service and a mission focus. And so the early church, if you look at Acts 2:42, you can kind of see the elements there. But the verses following, you see at this attitude of their possessions didn't even matter to them anymore. They were freely giving mm-hmm. to their community. And so we really want to be a church here that isn't just gathering together but kind of hoarding our stuff, but really thinking about how can I serve and live out the gospel in my community in a way that honors God and also proclaims the gospel. And so we think that looking at all these small groups scattered throughout the community, what better way than to ask them to start focusing on their neighbors and the people around them and looking ways for to serve or to proclaim the gospel.